Welcome back. Now we're going to set up the OptiFiber Pros for a successful OTDR test. And the first thing we're going to do is create a project.
So what is a project?
Good question, Amanda. A project, think of it as a folder where you can store all your test setup information, including cable IDs. Now, with our previous generation of OTDRs, you could only have one setup, and that worked if the tester stayed with that installation. But when that tester leaves that installation and goes to another installation, you have to reconfigure it for that installation, and that means changing the setup. Whenever you change the setup, that's a potential error. So what's great about the Versive platform and this OptiFiber Pro is I can create up to 100 projects in advance within the tester. So when this tester leaves here today in Everett and I go to, say, Edmonds, which I'm going to go to in a moment, I can simply just change the project across to Edmonds and I get my test configuration and my cable IDs for Edmonds. So let's create a project. It's a taptive interface, which means if I see something, I'll just tap it and it should be able to change it. So we see project on the screen there. So go ahead and tap project and change project and new project. And we're going to type in Edmonds, my favorite city. Awesome. Then you get your basic setup. Because we have the OptiFiber Pro module in the back, it's automatically gone to a default OTDR configuration. Let's take a look at that. So the first thing on there is the type of OTDR test. And there are a number of options here. So go ahead and tap on test type for me. We're not going to do all of these today. This is just a getting started video. The first option on here is auto OTDR, which is one of the most common settings. The reason why is if you leave it in auto OTDR mode, it will decide what the pulse width, the averaging, and all the ranging, and all the other stuff that you typically manually have to set up. Now, if you're an OTDR person, you may not like auto OTDR and you want to set this up yourself. You want to set your ranges and your pulse widths and your average each time yourself. That's totally fine. Second option on the list here is manual OTDR. So you can still do that, go in there and set up all your pulse widths in there. You'll also see data center OTDR. If you're doing certification of cabling systems, please don't use this one. This one is specifically for troubleshooting in data centers where we want to try and get the very best dead zone possible. As a result, if you use data center mode, you only get one wavelength. You need both wavelengths if you're doing certification. So go ahead and tap auto OTDR. And next thing down on my list here is the launch compensation. Now, whenever you do an OTDR measurement, you are going to be using a launch fiber. And it doesn't look like it, but these launch packs contain about 105 meters of fiber. We have to connect that into the link, otherwise we're not going to see that first connection. Of course, we don't want this to be part of our measurement. So what we'll do here in a moment is we'll actually remove that launch fiber from our measurement. Now you'll see that I've got two fibers on the table here. This other one I'm going to call my tail fiber. It's the same as this one, but I'm going to call it my tail fiber because a lot of folks today are still just using a launch fiber only. You should be making an OTDR measurement with a tail fiber as well. And when we come on to do launch compensation, I'll talk a little bit more about that. I'm going to leave it off. And the reason why I'm going to leave it off is when you do the launch compensation, it will turn this on automatically for you. So next down on the list is fiber type. So go ahead and tap fiber type for me. So here, this is a brand new tester. So these are the three options we've given you in there. And you've got to be thinking, there must be more fiber types than three inside the tester. And of course, you're absolutely right. Go ahead and tap more on there for me. So just like the CertiFiber Pro, you get all the options such as generic and the manufacturer and custom. Now be careful here because what you really want to do is go to the manufacturer's website and look at the data sheet for their fiber and make sure that's the information that matches up with what's in the tester here. You could create a custom cable type or you could just pick generic. And today we're going to pick generic. So tap generic. And just like our CertiFiber Pro before, we're going to pick OM3 fiber. So go ahead and tap OM3 fiber. And we are now set up for our fiber type. And finally on the list here, probably the most important thing is our test limit. So go ahead and tap test limit for me. Okay, and so just as before, we've given you some of the most common setups there, but of course there's got to be more. So go ahead and tap more. And here we see the TIA, the ISO folders, the application folders, a very lot of test limits inside this tester. So check your test specification. With OTDRs, a lot of people like to use their own test limits, and you can do that with the OptiFiber Pro. Go ahead and tap on custom for me. And yep, we're gonna go and create one. Excellent. So we can put the name of our custom test limit in the top here, and we have the four wavelengths that are supported with this module here, both multi-mode and single mode. So we can go into those menus and add in our connection loss, our splice loss, our fiber loss, and test to a tighter specification. That's very common with OTDRs, which again is another reminder, please check your test specification. You don't want to be retesting because you selected the wrong test limit. We're going to use a basic test today, so if you'd like to come out of that menu for me. Okay, there we go. And we'll go down to TIA, and we'll select 568. Now, because we selected the fiber type as multi-mode, our test limits here that we're going to be presented with will be multi-mode only. So go ahead and tap that for me. Excellent. And fundamentally, we've just set up the tester now. So the next bit that we're going to do is do the launch compensation. But here's one little catch. Don't forget to tap the save button down here on the right-hand side. Go ahead and tap save. Otherwise, we don't save our configuration. That's just a reminder also is one of the other benefits of setting up your projects is you can actually predefine the cable IDs, and you've seen us do that on the other videos. And we're gonna do that again here. So on the cable IDs, you'll see new ID. So go ahead and tap that. And we'll pick a typical simple fiber ID. So we'll start with 01A. So if you'd like to tap in 01A. And then go down to the next one, and we'll end in 12B. Excellent. Now, you'll also see that we get to choose what sort of test we want those assigned to. And we're doing an OTDR test today, and when you look at the OTDR, you'll see it says N1 and N2. We're going to do a fully standards compliant measurement. We are going to be measuring both directions. So go ahead and tap N1 and N2 on the boxes there. And then once we've done that, we'll go ahead and tap save. That's our OTDR setup with our cable IDs and our test limits. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to set a launch compensation and do a successful OTDR measurement.